Shalom, brothers and sisters. Once again, it's the voice of Brother Tazadaq coming at you through the spirit of Yahweh Bahasham Yahweh Shah. Today is, according to them, their calendar, January 6, 2012. I would like to reserve all of my rights according to the Bill of Rights and the Constitution of the United States. This is not legal advice. I do not offer legal advice. This is for entertainment, educational, and information purposes only. If you need legal advice, seek yourself a lawful attorney and please be advised. If you use this information to fall flat on your face, it's your fault because you did not research what was said herein. So I'd like to continue on. This is part two, to jurisdiction by contracts. So, as I was saying, there are other agents, the FBI, the CIA, the DEA, the BATF, etc. They begin their legal intrusion into the affairs of we the people of the States United of America. So by swearing under the penalty of perjury, we have just stated that we are an Internal Revenue Service agent, a 14th Amendment citizen of the United States Corporation, and are witnessing against our own self. Do you follow me? American people never have to swear under to penalty or perjury concerning any United States corporation or unincorporated banks, lendings, institution, or IRS. We are living souls. They are fictions / corporations. They are not a piece of paper and only exist in the minds. I'm sorry, they are a piece of paper and they only exist within your mind. They're legal fiction. They're legal fictions. Oh, I know they're going to come after me for this one. Now, since Title 26 codes, rules, regulations, procedures, and statutes are for the employees of the Internal Revenue Service, and they must, under their section 6065, that any declaration, document, paper, letter sent must be accompanied by a declaration made under the penalty of perjury. Excuse me. Now, any document you receive from the Internal Revenue Service must be sworn to under penalty of perjury, or you're not required to respond. But only send it back and tell them to swear under penalty of perjury. And then you will answer them. This is not legal advice. This is for entertainment purposes, Officer Ricky. So, as we are taught growing up in the corporate school system, well, the public school system's a corporation, to those of you that think foolishly didn't know, that we were to fulfill all contracts if we signed them. Now again, the trick is created by the United States Corporation was to come up with a contract in which only the living soul would sign. For the reasons a corporation cannot sign the unilateral contracts they require us to sign is they must sign under penalty of perjury that the contract is true and correct. Thus, the contracts for jurisdiction and jurisdiction by contract was the only way that they could trick us in their schemes of being their slaves. But once you come into the right knowledge, you don't have to be their slaves, their tools, they're fools anymore. Now, what about traffic tickets? I'm still getting many responses about traffic tickets. Now, there are always offers to contract. I said it before, I'll say it again. We then have 3 days for rejecting their offers of contract. A traffic ticket is an offer to contract under the Truth in Lending and returning their contract torn in half, back to the municipal court, collection pallet, Again, this is for entertainment purposes only. For entertainment purposes. If you wait past 3 days, you must call and set a court date. Put in an affidavit into the court of records. Attached to the ticket, write in across the rejection. The affidavit would be about the policeman, Officer Ricky, i.e., he, she, whoever, did not have a contract with you for stopping you and violating your right to travel and your right for privacy. The policeman did not have a license to practice law and was committing a commercial crime. So show up on the day of the hearing, and the policeman will not dare show up. Now, this principle applies to each and all contracts with the United States Corporation and all of the unincorporated parts of this scheme. Because it's a scheme, brothers and sisters. Right across the contract offer, the following. Your offer, get out a sheet of paper for entertainment purposes and write this down. Let me give you a second to get it. Make it kind of quick because short on time. So, right across the contract offer, the following. Your offer of contract is hereby rejected and returned to you, unsigned, in full, according with truth and lending. Any further correspondence from the signer of the document and heirs, agents, assigns must be done under penalty of perjury. If you are representing me, or assuming that you represent me, you are fired. Put an explanation point behind that for entertainment purposes. Remember, this is what you're going to put part two for entertainment purposes only. Remember that any further correspondence not signed under the penalty of perjury concerning, referring back to number one, is returned and answered the same way. So what about property? What happens to it? In 1933, with the Declaration of War from the United States Corporation against the citizens of the 48 states, there came a declaration that all property now belonged to the state, as in the United States Corporation, and actually would be used for the good of the United States Corporation. Another scheme. So a scheme was devised to trick the people into contracting their private property through a third party away from the people. Now, how is this done? This is done through registration of property. Oh, you want to register your vehicle? You want to register this? You want to register that? Watch this. Be it a house, land, car, etc. And it is done at a county level upon registration. They simply get people to sign a certificate of title. Certificate of title. Please listen. UCC-1. A lien. Disguise. So the car is obvious, while the house and the land are done by getting the person to sign a document that in turn is signed by a representative of the state, which is another way of placing a certificate of title against your house and land. Now, this document, when traced through its creation from the statutes, simply states that it must be signed and registered with the state. And if not done within a period of 45 days, it can be claimed by anyone. The state claims your property. Deception. Deceived again. Deceived. This is, the people have been deceived. This is utter deception. Now, so how do you claim your property back? That's the question that's going through many of you had. Let me see if, do I have time? I got about 4 minutes. How do you claim your property back? That's the question for entertainment purposes. I'm not an attorney. I do not offer legal advice. This is for merely entertainment purposes. So how do you claim your property back? The secret is in the claim. People work on claims, i.e. who put their stake on the claim first. So the government works in secret. If you do not claim it, the government will. The government works on charges and complaints. People work only on claims. So who has the claim? Who has the claim? Step one. Consent paper. Take a UCC-1 form. Fill it out. Learn how to fill out a UCC-1 form. I'm trying to give you a brief description. I need to close this out. Fill in the corporation debtor as the state of New York. B, fill in the individual debtor as the governor of the state of New York. C, fill in the secured party as yourself in the upper and lowercase letters, the living soul. D, in section 4, put a full description of the property as given by the county when they send you a tax statement. E, check the box for a search for state of New York or governor of the state of New York with a claim against your property. Now, of course, you're going to replace New York with the state that you're in as an inhabitant. F, on the bottom line, print the state of New York and the governor, whoever he may be, of your state. G, then sign your name as a secured party. And H, file it with the Secretary of the State of New York. Now, for this information, an attorney would charge you probably a few hundred dollars. But this is just for entertainment purposes. Now, do this with your car and any property that is registered with the state ASAP. Oh, they're going to hate me for this one. Brothers and sisters, I don't expect to be around much longer because I think, you know, I'm going to be really censored. Too much information is starting to slip through. I don't even know if this video will be uploaded. If it does, all praise is due to the Most High. In conclusion, can I touch on property taxes? I've got about a minute. I'll try to rush through this real quick. Property taxes. After you do a UCC-1 statement, you will not receive any property taxes statement. So if you do, simply write back to the county assessor collecting, you know, the county assessor collector, write him the following. Dear, let's say, Bugs Bunny, county assessor collector, I, Officer Ricky, with the power of attorney, in fact, for representing Officer Ricky at, you know, address, written out full, no abbreviations, state, zip code, I advise putting that in brackets, in all of his or her commercial affairs and in receipt of the attached regarding, without prejudice, do hereby notice you. I received your offer to contract, which is the jurisdiction, and you did not sign your demand for money under the penalty of perjury.
Is this a notice of debt?
I cannot, nor will I make a legal determination about the document you have sent. I am hereby rejecting your offer for contract, which is jurisdiction, and returning unsigned the same in full accord with the Truth and Lending and Fair Debt Collections Act. Any further correspondence in this matter from the signer